okay, I want a little video about, I don't know, what's the best kindling hatchet or something? Quite a few hatchets here. I suppose it's a pretty hard question to answer. It's sort of, you have one hatchet, I guess that's the best one you have, but it's, like I've bought all these little small hatchets, like these little, it's a Woods brand, like mini hatchets, this Jeep branded one, which you can get, there's a Schrade version of it too, it's like their Skax 10 or something. My little Halterfer's classic mini trekking hatchet. It's the next biggest one of them, like Collins hatchet. You got the Fiskars. What do they call it? 14 inch? No. 13 inch hatchet? Anyway, it's an X7 anyway. And the certified tube handled one, which is, there's all kinds of different ones of these. We got the Still branded hatchet. This one's got like a 15 inch handle or something. It is sort of German style. It's got the big chunky handle and everything. But it's, I don't know, it seems like when you, more you use these things, sort of the smaller ones seem to like not work. They work well for some stuff, but terrible for other things. You sort of end up with these in-between ones, like the Collins one. The Fiskars is really nice because of the super light handle and all the weight is basically on the head. Even this thing is pretty useful for most stuff, long as, you know, after you sharpen it, even though it has kind of a weird balance thing going on. Still is good for breaking out bigger stuff to make kindling, but it's kind of too long and clunky and chunky and stuff for doing the smaller stuff, but the, like the profile of it, it's, you know, it splits well and stuff. But I don't know, it's hard to really, like this one almost seems to be the best, and the Fiskars, and even the tube handled one, they seem to do pretty much everything. Like you can break up the bigger-ish pieces and make some really small little pieces out of them. Like you can make stuff like this. The little ones, you can break up stuff that's been, you know, has trouble breaking up pieces this big. You know, you can make that stuff smaller, but it's, so they sort of, I don't know. Like stuff like this is good to carry around. But they're, like this one got like a 9 inch handle. So it's, you know, it's cute and everything, but it kind of falls. Like this seems to do as much work, and this one's way cheaper. It's got a way thinner, bit is thinner, and it's all one piece, and it's, I don't know. It's pretty nice. But, and this one is, I don't know, it's just too light, too, like it's great to carry. It doesn't hardly weigh anything. It weighs about as much as some knives, but it's sort of, it's got no wedging at all, basically. It's, but for making the small kindling, it's basically, get it stuck into it, or you cut through it, and then you twist it. Like stuff like this, you're not going to break this off. Like, a, you know, you get all the experts on the internet, you know, don't be twisting the handle and stuff. Like some of these, you know, like Collins one has got a ginormous eye on it. Like you're not going to break this by twisting it. And if you do this for any amount of time, you learn what you can get away with. You know, you break a handle or something, and even like cheapo stuff like this, this tube handle, it's the same diameter on any direction. So it should have the same strength going this direction or this direction. You know, if it's stuck and you're wrenching on it, then yeah, maybe you might collapse it or something. But I've never seen that happen. Like, most of them, they get dented and then they, you know, buckle. But it's just sort of, what's the big internet motto thing there? It's like, you know, get good. People that complain about stuff breaking and whatever. Probably something like this that cost me quite a bit of money. I probably wouldn't wrench on it as much, but you got a short handle, so you can't put as much leverage on it. So it's leverage. In the Fiskars here, it's like strong as hell too. So, you know, I've wrenched on these things quite a bit. So anyway, we'll start with one of these and see what we can do with it. I think this is oak. That's what it looks like. Very stringy, but a straight grain anyway, so it does split good. It just splits all kinds of splinters come out of it when you split it. So you can wrench on stuff a little bit, you know what you know. Plus it's your axe anyway, I don't care if you break it. Why should you care if I break mine? Like, so this is pretty stringy stuff. Down for some reason that way. We'll go this way. Looks straight grain, but apparently it doesn't want to split. I think this X7 kind of Fiskars is the right size for doing most of this kind of stuff. Like, they have the smaller one. I think they still make it. They probably have the same issue as those other short hatchets. But you get stuff down like this. That's a pretty good job. That's about as far as you really need kindling. Let's split that. So this one works pretty good. So you got some of these smallerish ones. Pretty good for stuff like this, but that almost seems about it, and you know, light chopping, like it's not pretty thin bit and stuff, so it's pretty limited what you can really use these for. So but it's just, I don't know, just kind of pretty specialist little hatchets like this. So like that. This one's 9 inches. I think this one is like 10 inches. I think it's not a terrible lot better, but it does have a thinner blade on it, so it does sort of cut through easier. So it does seem to make it easier in that way. So you can make nice little pieces of. So you can make it smaller. Try to. I guess. This booger got peace. Okay, we can. So what do we do with this? That's stringy old stuff, isn't it? Pretty good. I used to carry this around quite a bit. That's a pretty good job for what it is. But I think it's the sort of thing you don't demand more from what the thing's capable of. Not one tool can do everything, but I guess it's good to have a selection of hatchets and stuff. Plus it's more fun, right? But then you get big still hatchet here that it'll work, but it's just too big and clunky for this sort of fire stuff. If it bite in, it would help. Jeez. It's just, I don't know, it's overkill. So it's just a little too big for that kind of stuff. But stuff like the Collins hatchet here, it has a nice thin profile. You can split with it if you want. Handle's short enough. It's a little chunky up top here, but you're not going to bust it off when you're wrenching on it. But, see, it'll go right through and then twist it and stuff. So it does a pretty good job. And that's pretty cheap when it's on sale. You got your tube handled stuff, which does a pretty decent job most of the time. Piece of beach or something. What call the surface area? Well, stringy and nasty. That stringy stuff. Job. And they're always cheap. Like, you can get these pretty much anywhere. It's got to sharpen most of them, because most of them are god-awful dull. But not sharp enough. You probably could thin it further, but yeah. It's a pretty nice, kindling. But I think the Fiskars here is probably one of the better for the money, and you get it right from the store. It's good. It's got a nice balance. Like, the weight is all in the head, so it's right nice that way. Much indestructible. They're fairly inexpensive. They're like 20 odd is 25 bucks or something in the States. This one, I think in Canada when they're on sale, they can pay entirely like 31 bucks for this. I guess pretty sure it's 14-inch hatchet, they call it. But it's sort of like the X7 without the rubberized grip thing down here. Hard time going wrong with the little Fisker's hatchet for doing those kindling stuff. Like this piece here, I split this using this. I just put it on it and hit it with that. This thing is on the back. So this has got really nice wedging profile, so it's, you know, splitter, but they cut like awesome, like great. So they're tough, they got a nice balance, as I said. So probably for the price, that's probably the, if you had to just pick one of these, it's a little bit longer than the lighter ones, but it weighs, like its weight is low. You can actually do a lot of work with it. So that's what I think anyway. So I think overall between all of these, the probably the Fisker's is probably the best one. It comes with a nice sheath, like some of the other ones don't, like this one, you know, the Still does. These come with a crappy sheath. What the hell is it? Anyway, it's one of those like Nugahyde things. Collins just comes with that thing. You know, this one comes with a sheath, but it's, you know, better for $120 or whatever. And these Jeep ones came with two sheaths. This thing comes with the sort of, I think it's leather, but it's hard to tell if it is or not. It almost looks like reconstituted weirdo leather, but these are pretty little sheath, carry it and stuff. I think the new ones have a belt thing on the back. That's something you care about. But they're weather resistant. You can, get wet and then get hot, cold, whatever. The cold doesn't seem to bother them. You know, people complain about the handles, but not seen it. So anyway, thanks for watching, and we'll talk to you later.